Popful Mail. I know, it's Sunday, which is not even close to Friday. It is not even in the same ballpark. And I'm sorry. I had a lot to do on Friday and Saturday. Man, they really do not want me in this place. I had a lot to do on Friday and Saturday, and this area is extremely difficult compared to the rest of the game, and it required a lot of practice on my part before I felt comfortable recording a video. We're going to use the amulet for the first time ever in this playthrough. What the amulet does is it prevents you from taking any damage, and it also prevents you from dealing damage while it's equipped. And you can see that bar down at the bottom shows you how much usage of the amulet you have left. So you can get a lot of use out of one amulet if you just need to equip it for a split second, which is usually the case. There's usually just an area like that would require, I mean, you can get through it without the amulet. It would require either a lot of luck or a lot of skill, neither of which I have in abundance. So, I mean, the amulet's there for a reason. I haven't really had a need to use them up to this point. But I might go back and grind for some money and buy a few more before this is all over. Ah, damn it. Oh, your speed works against you once again, Mew. I mean, I know it's only a point of damage, but it's the principle of the thing, damn it. Oh god. Stay away from me, helmet head. I could switch to golf for this part. It's a little easier to dodge those things, but that would require more effort than I'm willing to expend. I will switch to golf for this part, though. His jumping height and his slowness are definitely an asset here. This area is not really that hard, it's just time-consuming. And if you don't know what you're doing, then you can easily fall to your doom. But with a little bit of patience and a little bit of foreknowledge, this area is easy to breeze through. I'm not even going to worry about that night thing. He is under my radar. Or I'm under his radar. I don't really know how that expression works. To the left, there's just a flying knighthead thing and a dead end, so we are just going to go this way. Let me tell you, your instinct here is to want to jump to the other platform, but that is not a good idea. You just want to step onto the other one. Doop-a-doop-doop-doo. And once again, this thing insults my coolness by calling me dorky. I have had quite enough of that. And we're going to drop down here and head over to the right to get a couple cool items before we head back. Well, I don't know about a couple cool items. A cool item. A helmet. That's pretty cool. It's like the amulet, but instead of making you invincible, it just reduces the amount of damage you take. Then down here, we have a flying knight to dispatch, and we have some gold bullion, which I don't really know how useful that is at this point in the game. It's still only worth 500, and the enemies are just dropping so much gold at this point. I'm pretty sure they're giving you like 300 or 400 a pop. So, I mean, I'll take it. You know, why not? We have an apple down here, and we are going to jump back. And I'm going to quit my stone shoes just in case I can't make this jump, which I usually can't. I usually end up falling right there in those spikes. But we made it through unscathed, and there are another pair of stone shoes over here. Or there is another pair, I should say. Sorry. I try to avoid subject-verb disagreement whenever I can. And back we go. I saw that coming. Nothing I could do about it. I was facing the wrong way. But we have plenty of fruit, so a little bit of damage won't be that big of a deal here. Just as long as we don't accidentally take too much damage and lose one of our elixirs. That is the thing I am trying to avoid. Damn it. I got mixed up. I thought I was in the place where the flying knights are. I'm going ahead and use the amulet strategy again to get through this area. I didn't have to, but better safe than sorry. Take this guy out. And there's nothing we can do over to the left at this point. We will have to come back there eventually. Right now, we have to continue heading down and this way. And, you know, I'm going to go ahead and save it just to be on the safe side. I haven't really been saving as often as I should lately. I am a bad video game role model. Remember, kids, save early and save often. This area is a little bit of a maze, so hopefully I don't get too lost making my way through here. Pretty sure I'm on the right track. Leap of faith! Oh god, stay away from me. No, no, no! Oh, thank god. I hate these things, I hate these things. I really hate these things. Alright. How many bananas do we have anyway? 6? Yeah, I'll go ahead and use one. Gives you 80 hit points. The second best healing item in the game. The best healing item is the melon, which I'm sure I've missed a few of. And big open courtyard area, similar to where we fought the last boss. Come on, Flyboy. I like how it only drops those healing herb things for like 3 parts of the game. The rest of the game, you never see them. It's like right at the beginning from the spiders, and then in the mines, you get some from the snails, and then this part. And that's like the only 3 times you see them during the game. For the most part, I'm sure there are exceptions to that rule. So yeah, exciting video this time. We actually have quite a bit we have to fight through. It's not just cutscenes and bosses. I know there's a magic mech thing over here. We just have to be patient. I could just use my amulet and blow through this part. Which I might do if this thing decides it doesn't want to cooperate. Yeah, screw it. I can always get more amulets. I might have to, oh, never mind. Oh, stupid screen scrolling. Okay, this is the part I was thinking of. Hi, guy. I want to borrow this, if you don't mind. So, Animal Crossing still going strong. I'm playing a little bit every day, which is how that game's meant to be played. I mean, some people are, you know, playing the hell out of it, and that's fine. You know, however you get enjoyment out of it. User door key. And I picked up Shin Megami Tensei 4 as well. I've never really played one of those games before. But it's a series I've always been kind of interested in. And I'm enjoying it so far. It's difficult, but it is quite rewarding. And yeah, that's been my video gameage. Well, and Terraria, of course. If you haven't been watching the Terraria streams, then you're missing out. They have been quite enjoyable. What I'm going to do is, after I finish Popful Mail, I'm going to spend a week or two and upload all the backlog of live streams, just one a day, until those are all up. And then I'll start the next LP, which will be Dungeon Hack, which was donated for by Kostya. And that is the plan. Gaul's going to be our monster for this fight. Damn straight, it was no small feat. Alright, the reason I switched to Gaul is because otherwise, you have to wait for him to attack with his sword before you can hit him, because it blocks all projectiles, except for Gaul's fire breath. When you run out of ammo, you have to head back here to the stairs. Don't go all the way down, because you will have to start the fight over. Wait for your stuff to rebuild. Don't jump up into the path of the sword. That is not a good idea. And he'll start to go crazy. But keep your distance and you can take him out pretty easily. Destroy the Fright Knight. Not to be confused with that movie. That was Fright Knight, not Knight.
Well done, my pitiful opponents! You've collected the last orb! But without the Dragonstone my clubster is guarding, you'll never open the gates to the Tower Pinnacle!
Clobster? Really? That sounds like not an intimidating enemy. But, we took out that boss. There's nothing over here to the right. Just a dead end. We have to backtrack to one of the areas I didn't go before, which is now open to us. So yeah, tune in next time for the Clobster. I don't know what that is yet, but I am very excited. Hopefully some sort of giant lobster. See you later.